black box, and he, you know, he shows me this thing, and I say to him, well, that's a nice box you've got there. Because he's trying to get me to agree. He's trying to get me to enter that controversy. And so in the end, you know, he starts to write out stuff. Well, give me your name. And I said to him, well, I'll give you my name upon proof of claim that there's a controversy here. And he said, well, do you know that I can just take you and lock you up? And I said to him, yeah, well, that's called force. Okay?
Or a threat.
Or a threat. Okay? And that's what pirates do. And all of you have kind of like grown up in the era of electronica, so I mean a lot of you would know Laurie Anderson. You know, in the 80s she had a song called Oh Superman, and there's a great line in that which says, when justice is gone, there's always force. And that's true, because if I feared anything, which I try not to fear anything, because fear is obviously an attractor for bad stuff, so if I feared anything it would be force, because, you know, I fear ignorance. Because every time that I've sort of been in a situation where I've had to be approached by these law pirates, they don't understand what I do, because they're not taught that, and they're not taught it for a reason. Or if they are taught, they've forgotten it, or they're not allowed to know about it. But essentially, they have their set of rules, because they're policing the person, the fiction, the corporation. Okay, they're doing their job, which is part of the Matrix. And they're coming and trying to intrude upon my private journeying in peace, or my private affairs, which they have no jurisdiction or no place to be in. Okay, so that's the only thing that would scare me, is force, because in all other senses, it's illegal to do that, for them to do that. Mm. They have no right in my private automobile to pull me over, to stop me, to find me, to do anything. I mean, if they said to me, you weren't wearing your seatbelt, I would say, well, you show me the injured party. You know? There's a myriad of laws and things that we kind of...
So you have to have done something wrong for them to be able to pull you over?
In their law, yeah. So all laws refer to corporations.
Right, yeah. So if you were drunk and you'd run someone down...
Well, if I'd run somebody down, I'd most likely run down an entity. And so I would be liable for the entity. Unless I was the agent for my all caps. Because, you see, you can only bring a court case or a claim against an entity. It will never, ever, ever come against a natural flesh and blood person. All claims, all insurance, for example. All of those things. You know, if it even came down to it, if we were in a courtroom and I had given up my rights and the judge said, okay, I'm going to order you to pay $1 million damage to this person for running them down or whatever the hell happened, and I could say to the judge, well, I shall pay, Your Honor, upon proof of claim that there is any lawful money in circulation backed by anything of value. Because there is no money to pay with. Right. So we all come back to this fictitious land again. It's an interesting kind of system. Mm. So that's the basis of the straw man, and who all of you are. I used to be too. What I had to do is I had to go through all of my cards, all of my accounts, my credit cards, threw those away, cancelled everything, threw away my license, realised I didn't need a driver's license because I don't drive anymore. I don't put into motion a commercial vehicle anymore. I simply journey. So I registered and had my own private plates for my automobile. And anything that I had to actually do business with or use my transmitting utility, my straw man, say if I wanted to get an account with electricity or a telephone or something like that, right? You need a transmitting utility. And the same with the bank. You have a bank account. They're not going to give you a bank account in your natural flesh and blood name. Okay. So you need your transmitting utility, but you still have to be the agent for it. But I made sure that every time I did, I took away the mister, because a legal fiction, is not gender-based. And I always made sure that the TM, the trademark, went on the end of it. And so I slowly, bit by bit, reassembled all of my cards. And when it came time to get a new port pass, I made sure that I put the all rights reserved, you know, agent signature on there. And they weren't going to give that to me. It took me an hour of talking to convince these people that was my signature.
I was surprised that it literally didn't take you years.
Yeah, well, I was in there for a couple of hours organizing the passport, and when it came time for them to actually accept my signature, that's what took an hour. Where they say, sign here, and I signed, and that's when the trouble started. So,
and what were they saying to you?
You can't do that. You can't sign like that. Then they actually went out and researched my past passport from years ago and said, you didn't sign like that before. So I actually had to say to them, whose signature is it? It's my signature. I sign how I want. Who tells you or the government who you are? So they asked me for, in the end, they asked me for a proof that I signed my name like that. And so I was able to pull out other documents or other things which I'd gotten beforehand, which are much easier to get, like your library card or something else. And I said, look, that's how I sign my name. I'm the authorized agent for the legal fiction that happens to look like my name. And so they gave it to me. A very, very unique situation to be in. Especially now, because Japan has started to bring in fingerprinting. Yeah. And they're bringing in fingerprinting
in America
to completely enjoin you with the straw man. Okay? Because when you go and, they take your photo, they put the fingerprints on there, it runs through the machine, and up comes the all capital letter, Mr. blah, 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 blah. That's you.
What happens in Australia when that comes in your case?
Well, I'm still the agent. So it can have, that's my photo, and that's my signature, but that's a piece of IP that I own.
Yeah, but will it still have your photo, your fingerprint, and that signature?
Sure, as the agent. As the agent for...
So adding electronic fingerprint to one of these documents has no... It's not an issue for you?
Not an issue for me, because I'm still... This is a document that I'm signing as the agent for a legal fiction.
Okay. There's a separation there.
Yeah, so I create the separation. Yeah. A very, very important separation, because the government can come along. I mean, the government owns your house. The government, whether you like it or not, they actually own a security interest in your home. If you've bought your home, perhaps they gave you a $7,000 grant, or they have like a first home buyer's grant. Or when your child is born, I know when ours was born, they gave us $3,000 because they wanted to buy a security interest in our child, in our child's straw man. So I've done that for our child. Is I've always signed as the agent for him, okay, so that when he grows up, he will be his own agent, okay, for his legal fiction. Because you need the legal fiction in this commercial world to exist, otherwise you can't do business, you can't earn any money, because they've created this whole weird fiat legal system, which is like this giant matrix.
It's like a big game that you have to have a piece.
Yeah.
To move around and play the game with.
Yeah, but you can, by having a transmitting utility, you can stay out of the liabilities. I mean, I've got a private agreement between myself and the transmitting utility, whereas it holds me harmless against all claims. So if any claim came against that all capital letter fiction, I'm completely okay. That's the kind of position that I think everyone needs to get themselves into, because at the moment you're all vulnerable.
And how easy
vulnerable.
Is it to get yourself into that position?
It takes time. Probably, I'd say it would take at least 3 months if you started it today. To go through and change all of your details on your bank accounts, your electricity bill, your phone bill.
And what about tax and stuff like that?
Tax is an interesting one. Tax, you can challenge tax and taxation. However, you'd be silly to do so. There's a lot of people who challenge tax and never get anywhere. A lot of people who go to jail for not paying tax, right?
Everyone,
all those
group of people
things.
That you really don't want to fight with.
Yeah, you don't want to fight. And that's the whole point. There is no fighting.